Hello, my name is Kristen Ghodsee, and I am the host of the AK-47 podcast. So this is a play on AK-47. Obviously, AK stands for Alexandra Kollontai, and 47 refers to the number of discrete works that I am going to read and discuss on my podcast over the course of several years. So today is February 8th, and I believe that I have been doing this podcast now for 2 years, and I have covered about half of the 47 that I planned to read. Some of these pieces require multiple episodes, and then I also have bonus episodes where I bring guests on to discuss various things about either Alexandra Kollontai's writings or her life or various things that are going on in the world around us today. I am really excited to have such a wonderful community of listeners around the world, of quite a few international people who listen to the podcast. I am a professor of Russian and East European studies at the University of Pennsylvania, and I've been doing research on women's issues both before and after the collapse of communism in Eastern Europe for about 20, 22 years. I'm an ethnographer by training. I've done a lot of primary field work, not only in Bulgaria, but also in the eastern part of Germany. And I've also traveled extensively throughout the region and have many colleagues and friends in this part of the world. So I'm really interested in the intersections of political economy with women's lives. And I think that Alexandra Kollontai's writings, even though they are over, many of them are over 100 years old now, are a really wonderful window into understanding early socialist theorists' thinking about the ways in which the political and economic systems under which we live impact our very personal, intimate lives. So Alexandra Kollontai is one of the first real theorists, I think, to do a proper Marxist analysis of love and relationships and family and motherhood. And what she does is she sort of takes historical materialism and she applies it to our ideologies around what it means to be in love and what it means to forge relationships with our colleagues and comrades and friends and lovers and family members and so on and so forth. And, you know, she had a lot of really strong opinions. She was initially a Menshevik. She later became a Bolshevik after the onset of the First World War because she was a pacifist. And, you know, Lenin makes her the first Commissar of Social Welfare after the October Revolution in Russia. And for a while, she has an incredible amount of influence on the construction of Soviet family policy as a member of the high echelons of power in the new Soviet government. But she eventually sort of falls afoul of both Lenin and Trotsky because she joins this thing called the Workers' Opposition, which are people that were sort of opposed to Lenin's idea of war communism and the centralization of authority and really wanted power to be devolved to the Soviets, to the workers in their individual enterprises. And she also was very critical of Lenin's new economic policies. And so eventually she gets exiled as a diplomat. It's kind of a nice exile. She's initially sent to Norway, then she goes to Mexico, and she ends up serving a very long time as a diplomat in Sweden, and she's there during the Second World War, and she's, you know, very instrumental in brokering a peace between the Soviet Union and Finland, and gets twice nominated for the Nobel Peace Prize. She doesn't win, but she is nominated twice, and she is largely seen as kind of a grand old stateswoman. Eventually, she ends up back in the Soviet Union, and she dies just before her 80th birthday in 1952. So she left behind an amazing corpus of writings. Many of them have been translated into English, and what I do on this podcast is I try to introduce these various writings. I try to read from the original, not the Russian originals, obviously the English translations, and then try to give some context for what Alexandra Kollontai was thinking and writing about in that particular moment of time, and how Alexandra Kollontai's writings and the example of her life can really inform our own politics today in 2020, 2021. I started this podcast in 2019, and I'm still really interested in how to make Alexandra Kollontai relevant to the world today, because I think there's still a lot for us to learn. And I think many people are very frustrated by the ways in which capitalism kind of commodifies our emotional lives, our affections, and our attentions. And Kollontai gives us a kind of blueprint, a kind of way of thinking outside of the normal sort of liberal feminist box on these issues. And so I hope you will join me. I largely do this as an audio podcast. This is the first time I've done a video, but I decided that, you know, you can see me and you can know that I am the person reading these wonderful texts that I think are so important and relevant to us today. And I'm hoping that by doing this podcast, I'm sort of bringing Kollontai's work largely to a new generation of young people and interested parties who have never heard of her or have never accessed her writings, never really thought about it, and that people will get interested in reading much more broadly some of the original texts of some of these socialist thinkers from the 19th and early 20th centuries that we tend to forget about because they were East European or European, and we, you know, we generally tend to read our own circle of knowledge and not really to think about the kind of knowledges, especially from women socialist theorists, other than perhaps maybe Rosa Luxemburg. There's a lot of wonderful material out there from people like Alexandra Kollontai or Clara Zetkin, and they can tell us a lot, Nadezhda Krupskaya, various figures that can tell us a lot about how a particular group of women were really struggling with building the first worker state in the world and the challenges, the real challenges that they met, not only from, you know, the capitalist West, but also from within the party, from their male comrades, sometimes the resistance of peasant women. There were all sorts of problems and challenges that these women had to face and eventually overcome. And I do think that their lives and their writings can be incredibly instructive for us today in the 21st century already. Yep. So thank you so much for watching this video, and I hope you enjoy the podcast. And if you have any thoughts or comments or questions, you can always email at alexandra.kollontai.podcast@gmail.com. Again, my name is Kristen Ghodsee. You can find out more information about me and my writing and my books at kristengodsee.com. That's pretty easy. I'll leave a link in the show notes to this video. I've written 10 books on issues around socialism and post-socialism. I'm still working on new books about various leftist ideologies. And I'm always thrilled and excited to hear from listeners from around the world who have thoughts and suggestions for things that I should read or topics that I should discuss on the podcast. So as always, thank you so much for watching and listening, and keep up the good fight.